Coming to Northeast Wisconsin live from the Civic Media Studios at the City Deck Landing in Green Bay and featuring TV and radio broadcast veteran John Mino, along with the City of Green Bay's longest serving mayor, Jim Schmidt. This is Mino and the Mayor. Here are your hosts, John Mino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back, Mino and the Mayor, 97.9 FM, WGBW, 98.3 FM, WSS. And, of course, the Civic Media Amp. Special thanks to Mary Jane Herber, librarian, historian, Brown County Library. You know, if you want to know where the skeletons are buried, she'd be the person that would know. She is just great, and she's going to be on your show coming up on Sunday, which is, I think, great.
Yeah, and it's going to be fun having her on the show. We interview mostly, political leaders, right? We've had, different village presidents and mayors on, but she's going to give us more of a historical perspective on, and I think one of the things that would be interesting, and I'm really interested to talk to her about, is elections are pretty partisan right now, and have they always been that way? And then I want to talk to her, and I said, look, I want you to name names, but who were some of the strong leaders that made this city what it is? So it's going to be fun.
That's
I think people
great.
Listen to that. And we got Brian Johnson coming on too. And he's, of course, an alderman. And so, thanks for, Sunday at 1.
Well, we have one of our favorite people in the entire spectrum of our world. If we're going to be talking about flutes and we're not going to be talking about cooking or playing quarterback in semi-pro football, have to call you Chef Ace Champion?
No, actually Good Buffalo.
Good Buffalo now. That's okay.
Well, when I'm playing the flute.
That's what I mean.
Then when I'm in the kitchen, it's back to Chef Champion.
Got it. Okay. But just want to make sure.
But what if you're going to those events?
Because I was watching a show the other night where a guy was interviewing somebody. He says, well, sir, he goes, I prefer you call me doctor.
I mean, I love that
really?
One.
So I wasn't sure, Ace, if you wanted, that was your number one forte.
From a marketing standpoint, I don't know that you should have two different names because there are times where you cook and play the flute.
There is.
So how do we introduce you then?
I don't know, man.
Okay, so let's go.
And you play football at the same time, right. So we don't know what it is.
So you think about it, talk to your wife, but maybe Ace Buffalo is where we're going to go.
Ace Buffalo, I like it.
I love that.
Jim with the ideas in the morning.
Well, we came up with my idea.
We have the best
this morning,
ideas in the morning.
I said, how would you like to reach for new health? And for a healthy life, because of the shakes I'm making now.
Oh.
I lost 4 pounds from these shakes I'm making.
Wow.
Yeah. What was my motto again, Todd?
See, this is how successful it was.
What was my motto again?
His motto is...
healthy, nutritious, and oh so delicious. What do you think?
I like it.
Grab a mug of healthy.
What do you think about that?
I think that's a TikTok wonder.
Yeah. Thank you, my friend.
But
thank
Ace,
friend.
I just want to say
by the way, I volunteered you for something.
I get that a lot often, actually, believe it or not.
So, but you might like this one.
Okay.
It was, what's the gentleman's name that we had come in? He's an entrepreneur here. It's right before the Jared Bush thing. He's the artist, amazing artist. Todd, he does the cartoon artwork. He's got the shop on Broadway, I believe it is.
Oh.
I can't think of his name off the top of my head. You know who I mean.
I do.
So he's tried out for a couple of different NFL teams and stuff like that. He still doesn't want to give up the dream. So he said he wants to get somebody to throw some passes to him. I volunteered you for that.
Oh, I'm down with it.
That's what I thought.
Hey, you know what else is cool is I might be Carrington Valentine, the rookie cornerback.
Yeah.
His private chef.
No kidding.
Yeah, and you better believe we're going to be throwing the ball
damn
around.
Right.
Yeah, we'll take some pictures and stuff like that. Maybe I can see if I can drag him down to the
show. So I volunteered you to work out with him.
I'm down.
Okay.
I'm down. 100%.
Excellent. Because I told him I was just too busy. She said, man, you look like you can spin it.
He didn't say that.
Yeah, he did. Eric Brundage is his name. Yep.
Great guy. Back to what I see him.
No, he did. He said, man, did you play ball? I mean, a little bit. So were you a quarterback?
Okay, I was sitting there. I didn't hear
and
that.
He goes, you look like you could really throw it.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
And
I said, I'm too busy.
I just want to continue with this line of thinking. He lost 4 pounds, right?
Right,
he's,
right.
He's saying it's because of this banana and raspberry thing he threw together chocolate milk. He had his gums surgery.
You don't have to talk about my private.
Did he have 4 pounds of gums that he lost?
No, I'm just saying when you get your gums when you get your gums treated, you don't eat.
You eat less.
Oh, you don't eat less.
Wow. So we need to do a retake in about a month.
See if they still work. Just like that.
No, he is onto something.
Wow.
Because he said this drink fills
you up. It fills you up so much, it's
and
unbelievable.
That's good.
Yeah.
So it's the healthy Ozempic.
I'll have to check those ingredients for you.
Thank you, my friend. Yeah. I will even at one of your cooking events, I will even come there and make some for people.
Oh, boy. Look at that.
I'm telling you. Yeah.
So, Ace, what do you got going on? I know you have a lot going on.
I got a lot going on, man. I'm cooking. I'm playing. You know, I got a charity tonight at the Giving Tree in Howard where, you know, they auctioned me off. And last year we did three dinners, raised over $9,700.
Wow.
You know, so.
That's fantastic.
So, Ace, just people who maybe haven't heard or seen you before, you are a, is it renowned? Is that the right word? A chef. And you you have your own TV show.
Yes.
And you also study music, but it's not just your typical musician. You study music that affects the health and wellness.
Yes.
You have certain pitches and certain instruments to help the heart, the digestive system, you know. And so you are like a super interesting guy, and
you are
marketing that. Or I guess we are. Some of these auctions, they buy you. You come to the house, do a home dinner. And
multi-talented.
Right. Yeah. So tonight you have the thing at the Giving.
Yes.
That's cool.
Yes.
But you have something big coming up, right?
I do. Very honored. I'm actually a presenter / performer at this year's Wisconsin Flute Festival.
Nice.
Yeah.
And where is that?
That's in Madison.
Okay.
So it's at a new art center that they just built. And they have flutists from all over the world.
Cool.
And it's a pretty big deal. I'm the only flute player that doesn't play a concert flute. The only bamboo tree flute player there.
Wow.
Cool. Yeah.
Whole different element.
Oh, yeah. Bringing in something new.
Very cool. Know?
Something new.
And it's so interesting.
It's what you do.
Too.
Right.
Yeah, and flute, that's a great instrument. But again, I just tell us a little bit more about, right? Yours is more geared toward health.
Yeah, so all these flutes, if you notice, every single country in the world, they had a flute. Flute and a drum is our most ancient instruments. And back in the day, you know, for health issues like anxiety, depression, there was no Xanax back in 400 BC. So they had to go to either the flute player, or they call them shamans or some type of spiritual doctors, and they would play these flutes in certain frequencies. So it all based down on the wood, what type of wood, and then the actual player too as well, you know, because we don't read sheet music. We kind of play from how we feel. So if we're trying to like help somebody or heal somebody and we're thinking those thoughts manifest in the frequency. And then through the breath that I breathe, it transfers through the flute into the, not just the body, but whoever is around. So it affects animals. I played in the Oneida River and played it up to the water, and tadpoles literally swam up to my flute.
Seriously.
So it literally affects, if it has cells in the body, it will affect it.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Wow. Awesome. Yeah. In Madison, will you be doing that? Or what are you doing?
Yeah, I'll be.
That's a big deal.
It is a very big deal. And not just for me, you know, being the first time, but to introduce something non-traditional. Like I said, every single flute player is traditional with the concert flute. So I'll be doing education. Each flute that I pull out, I'll let them know what region is from. Like, for instance, this is the Japanese shakuhachi. Back in the 8th dynasty, you know, literally over 3,000 years old, the same flute that the Buddhist monks play as well as the samurais play. One of the hardest flutes in the world to play. So I'll be educating on that, and then I'll play them a piece.
Where do you find these?
eBay.
Okay.
Yeah.
You really?
Amazon is the one where you can't get them all.
Say, I traveled to South America.
So back in the 1950s, exactly. You know.
Like John says, we BS for a living. We could get a better story.
Let
me work on that.
I'm plugging eBay endorsing them.
So me and Ace, we're in South Africa. Yeah. And we're looking around.
In the jungle.
You wouldn't believe the conditions.
There's this black mamba that came after me. I saved Ace's life. I swear to God.
I started playing and he turned around.
Yeah. I grabbed that mamba by the throat and I strangled him.
Yeah. I actually got hit with the African tree, and then it magically, God, transformed into a flute.
Right.
And there it was.
There you go.
And there it was. Like that.
That's better. Much better.
A way to get on eBay.
I get it.
Much better.
I get it. Right. Until they start paying me, then I'll bring eBay back.
Tell us about the you're going to play something for us, right? And it's after the break. But how's the food portion going of your show?
Oh, it's phenomenal. I mean, even when I bring my flutes, I can't get away from the food part.
No.
There's always, so what are you going to cook? Can you do both? You know, they.
But you come from a part of the world where cooking and food is really important, right?
Right.
I mean, it's not just filling yourself up.
It's food for the soul. And what I realized is that people from New Orleans don't travel. And this is why you can go from state to state and you'll probably never really find a good amount of Cajun Creole. You'll always find Chinese, you'll always find Hispanic, but that particular cuisine is very unique to
Ask, because I just saw a great special on this, on Cajuns, basically per se. You don't consider yourself a Cajun though, right?
So there's Cajun and there's Creole.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
Okay. I think if you don't know it, we all just blend it together.
Yeah, Cajun is if you've ever, you know, I don't want to use the
They're
word.
They're from Newfoundland.
Yeah. They have a very thick accent. They're the ones who actually live on, I call it the jungle of Louisiana.
Yeah.
So it's the actual bayou. The Creole is a mix of South African, Indian, French, and Spanish. So we're kind of the uppity version.
Okay. But I just thought it was the first time I interviewed a guy by the name of Bobby Hebert.
Oh, yeah.
Remember Bobby Hebert?
One of the best quarterbacks in New Orleans.
And it's like, hey, he's playing for the Michigan Panthers. I go, hey, Bobby, welcome to Detroit. You know, how are you going to do, you know, being from Louisiana and living up here in Michigan? Oh, well, I see the winner. It should be putting the quarter in. It was just like that.
Yeah, it's
and
their
own
language.
I even asked the coach, I said, what did he say in the meeting? He goes, and he's from Oklahoma. He goes, son, I couldn't understand a word he said. Such a thick accent.
The guy on PBS who does the Cajun, is that Cajun or Creole? Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. I think he's Cajun.
He's Cajun. Okay. Yeah.
Food is very similar. The people are what's different.
Oh, I see.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I will. He's entertaining. I mean, all you chefs, all you good chefs are pretty entertaining.
Thank
so,
you.
It's nice to see. Okay. So you've got that going on, this thing. How can people, like, I think you'd be a very interesting guest house event.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So, you know, chefchampion.com is my website. You know, my cell phone, my email address is on there. So just feel free to reach out. I've been doing dinner and a show, but just by default, because you think when someone eats, their stomach is full, their soul is starting to get full, they're starting to get a little tired, and then they all kind of gather into the living room, dim the lights a little bit, and I play about 10, 15 minutes for them, and they're ready for bed.
I can imagine. That would relax you more than anything. We got to set it to a break here just a little bit, but we come back, Ace. I'd like to talk a little bit about this, about the flutes, and you brought a harmonica too.
Of course.
I love harmonicas.
We're there. Got a lot of rattle.
All right. I like that. Did you ever run into rattlesnakes when you lived in Louisiana?
Oh, yeah. Rattlesnakes, alligators,
really?
Raccoons. Yeah. That's
right.
Louisiana.
All right. We got to set a quick break. Ace Champion is with us. He's one of the greatest. We'll be back right after this. Hey! Thursday morning, 46 degrees in Green Bay, 45 in Appleton, 44 in Oshkosh. Got one of our favorite people here, Ace Champion.
In the house.
In the house. Now we're going to talk music. We talked some good food. Now we're going to talk some good music. I like that.
Yeah. It's all about the music. It's not just about the music. It's about the right music.
Absolutely.
You know, what I'm trying to do is open up the world back to the ancient days to where music was meant to be. You know, and we all know that music is healing, it's soothing, it's relaxing, it brings out emotions.
Yep.
And so these different flutes are all from around the world. I got an Egyptian clarinet over here. I got a Chinese shao. I have an Arabian flute for the Middle East. And then I have the shakuhachi that we were talking about.
Right.
And then I have a couple other things. These are actually Peruvian nuts. So they're meant to kind of give the ambience of water.
Absolutely.
You know, and then of course you got your shaker. So if you ever see any snakes around.
Yeah, that's where I got that from. Yeah.
Yeah. So I'll let you guys pick where you want to go. So when I play these, kind of imagine that you're actually in the region. So when I play this Egyptian clarinet, I want you to feel like you're actually in Egypt.
Bring it on.
Yeah.
Here we go. Ace Champion. And that's Egyptian.
That's an Egyptian clarinet. It's kind of a hybrid. It's kind of like if Egyptian met the Western world.
So that's what I was going to ask. Where did it begin? And then, you know, what countries picked up on it?
The flute?
Yeah.
Every single country.
They
all have their own version, and it's either made out of bamboo or some type of wood, so they're always all natural, no stainless steel or anything.
I was going to ask, so this looks like it would be handmade.
Yeah, all these are handmade, and that's why I have to order them directly from the region. Like Chinese flutes come from China. Yeah.
How do you get the different tones and the different notes?
So each flute, if you see the different holes in them, that's the different scales.
Okay.
So they actually have different scales and the type of bamboo that it is. Like these two are bamboo, but this is bamboo from North America and this is bamboo from the Middle East. So they're still going to sound different. And the maker is going to make them sound different too as well. Yeah.
Play something and incorporate. Can you, or do you need an assistant to incorporate the water?
Yeah. So these are Peruvian nuts. So
you want Jim to be your water guy?
You want me to be the water guy?
Jim to be my water guy? And look, here, you can be my shaker.
Yeah.
So every now and again, just give me a little.
Damn right, I will. Yeah.
We don't have to count off or anything. It's just whenever we feel it.
That's the beauty of this music.
Okay.
There's no script.
We're in.
Yeah. All right. We're going to go to.
I can do this like you can't even believe.
Let me start. Because I got the water, you know, and then get everybody in the zone.
In the beginning, there was water.
I'm just testing it, Jim.
Yeah, no, don't. Let me start. Yeah. Feel the water.
Yeah.
Okay, you're ready. That will shoot to number one.
We went to the Arabian. We were in Arabia.
How did you like our parts?
I loved it.
That's what really made it.
We just started a band.
We kind of carried you a little bit.
But you did. What would I do with that? You coming with me to Madison?
I am a musician. I just performed professionally.
Come with me to Madison.
All right. It was like, say, what we did, Ace, that maybe you didn't notice, was we brought it all in at the perfect time.
Yeah,
It all started with the water.
Look, right, it did. Look at the texts coming in, the texts that are coming in about, I feel better.
I've never had this
kind of energy.
I'm not going to therapy today. I don't need it anymore.
I'm saving the money on my shrink.
I see the one that says, thanks to Jim, this is all possible. Brought to you by
Look at that
Jim.
My shrimp can go to hell. Wow.
All right.
Love it. Good stuff.
Well, Ace, thanks for sharing this with our community. And you're down in Madison. You got a pretty far reach. Tell me about that cooking show on, was that 32?
No, every Saturday at 12:30 on CW 14.
14.
Yeah, right. Fox 11 Sister
It's
Station.
Cool.
All right.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
You got a nice kitchen to work in.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
oh,
they
yeah.
do. They do.
Yeah, yeah. I had my own studio. Now we're in LiveX.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we're in season 7 right now. So
fantastic.
That's great.
That's really popular. I got to ask one more thing about the flutes, though.
Yeah,
first thing. No. I bet there were. No. This is like, because I'm always big into building stuff. I can never build stuff like this. But the craftsmanship from thousands of years ago, literally.
Yes.
Some guy had so much talent, didn't read a book on it, didn't whatever, somehow figure out a way to hollow out some of these things, put these holes the right size, the right whatever. Don't you just have to have respect when you play one of these? Respect the man who put these together.
100%.
Yeah.
Because when I look at a tree and I'm just in awe.
How did that happen? Exactly. You know? That's what I mean.
And over 40, 50,000 years ago is when the first bone flute was found. So how did they know?
Exactly. Well, I love that.
Yeah. My guess is the tree, the branch of the tree was hollowed out and some birds had made holes in it. Johnny, the wind blew and the guy's like, I can bring that.
Ace?
Yeah. You know what I think? I think it was your ancestors, Jim. Yeah.
In Germany?
I think they did it. Yeah.
Us Germans.
In Germany.
That's,
yeah.
That's
they made their way to the jungles of Africa.
That would not be
yeah.
us.
You don't know. You get a DNA test. You'd be surprised.
Yeah. No. Okay. Well, we got 2 minutes left. We need to hear some harmonica. That's my favorite instrument in the world is a harmonica. Nice.
Great.
Why can't you do something like that?
I know, right? I feel so much better.
Barbershop.
Awesome. Barbershop is awesome.
All right.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Ace, it's always a pleasure having you here.
Always a pleasure
to be here.
You have
more skills, more talents than any six guys I know.
That's what life's about. It's all about growing, my friend.
Oh, man.
Like a tree.
Thank you very much. Don't be a stranger. And you're at Pete Schwab's show tonight, is that right?
Yes, yes.
Cool.
Right here. It's a great show.
Yeah, yeah. I'll be playing three segments. So.
Fantastic. Oh, wow. Pete is awesome. Ace Champion in the house. Always a pleasure. Thank you, my friend.
My pleasure. My pleasure. Be blessed.
Mind of the Mayor, back after this.
Take Mino and the Mayor with you anywhere. Download the Civic Media app today from the Apple Store or Google Play Store. And text the studio directly, all from the Civic Media app. Download it today. Now, once again, here's Mino and the Mayor, John Mino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back to Mino and the Mayor here, 97.9 FM, WGBW, 98.3 FM, WISS. And, of course, the Civic Media app. Special thanks to Ace Champion. How come some people have so many talents and others have so few?
Everybody's got talents. They just have to. They're different talents. You can't. They're different talents, Johnny. Everybody's got talents.
All right.
They do.
He's got a lot more than I do.
In music.
In everything,
he doesn't know.
I bet he's a better football player than I was.
Not a sports guy.
Hey, you know what he is, Tony? I asked him yesterday, I think it was. Todd, you might have seen this. It was National Crawfish Day.
Yeah.
And I asked him, how do you eat those? And he explained,
you got to suck the heads.
He's like, I'm not going to eat crawfish.
Yeah.
This segment brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, where you can turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. This gentleman sitting next to me, he took advantage of it. How great was it?
I just love it. I mean, we have a house. We have 22 windows in our house, and actually more than that because we did the third floor. But anyway, and it takes time, but it's so important because good windows, great installation, will save you money. It saves you on your heat bill, your air conditioning. And so it took us 3 years to do the whole house. But, you know, Pella was great. They put a plan together for us. Sometimes they offer financing, and I read ads on that. But, you know, when we go to people's homes, and when people, you know, people were spending more on their electric bill than their rent sometimes.
Oh, I believe that.
Can you believe that's?
And that's because of bad windows.
It's totally because of bad windows and doors. Yeah. Pella does doors too.
Yeah.
It just has worked for us, and then they look nice, and you know, we don't have.
The cool thing is, I mean, your house, you got that little plaque, and it was built in 1915.
Right.
But they don't stand out like there's something modern and whatever, whatever. They blended right in.
Yeah. With the new windows, and we don't have any curtains.
Yeah. I know. I was looking into your house the other day. Right now, get 0% interest after 36 months.
That was you.
That was me.
Slow-moving car.
Looking to see if you had that case of beer that Todd stole from you on your floor. Right now, get 0 interest after 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th.
That is a sweet deal.
Sweet deal. Once again, check it out. 0 interest, 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, no payments, 18 months. If you book before April 30th, it's getting near. Take ownership of your living space. Do like Jim did. Contact Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Yeah, and I just want to say one thing. We shopped that, too. I mean, we knew that was going to be a big investment in the house. But,
well, it is.
I mean, when it came down to price service, it was just hands down Pella. So anyway, I love them, and I would do it again, but they last so long. I'm not going to buy windows from them again.
I need some, so I want to talk to them.
Yeah, do it.
All right.
And they'll work with you.
All right. Excellent. Who's our next special guest?
Pat Tracy, Discover Oshkosh, the guy that knows everything going on in town.
All right. Hello, Pat.
Good morning, fellas.
Hi, Pat.
Hey, Pat, you got to help us out with something. So this summer, Jim and I have vowed that pretty much every Tuesday, or at least one day a week, we're going to just get in the car after our show, and we're going to travel to different places. Give us some cool places. One of the places I want to go to is the drive-in. Do they really have the roller skate servers?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. I've already been there.
Oh, it's
already
open?
Been there this year, guys. Artie and Ed's right on the lake.
Oh, I didn't know it was open already.
It's already open. It's amazing. And the girls have the skates on, and they are ready to go.
We're doing that. That's going to be our first place.
You think so? Okay.
Yes.
All right. We're going to stop in and see you. Well, you just join us. We're going to go there.
I'll be there.
Okay.
Excellent.
I think it's Tuesday travel, because Tuesdays are a pretty good day. So Johnny and I are going to, we got a couple other things on the list, but yeah, we want to start with Oshkosh. We love Oshkosh.
So we want you to kind of be our guru for that area where we should go.
Right.
Guys, I would love to host you for a little drive-through of Oshkosh. It's what I do.
All right.
Excellent.
And that's what we're going to do.
We want to do it.
So, all right. Cool.
So, Artie and Ads, we're going to start because, you know, tomorrow I'm actually filming the next installment of Why I Love Oshkosh.
Okay.
And we're moving directly into drive-in restaurants tomorrow.
Oh!
So, we're going to actually be at Artie and Ads.
Fantastic.
We're going to be filming there. And we're going to be at Leon's, which is the, like, to me, it's the original custard place in Wisconsin.
Okay.
Leon's? Have you guys been to Leon's?
No, I don't know Leon's, but I'd like to learn Leon's.
But I don't.
You have ice cream, like, for your early lunch and your late lunch?
Nice.
But isn't... You guys do two ice creams for lunch in a day?
We could do that. Because I'm on this new health thing, so it'll whatever I have afterwards won't matter.
Yeah. But okay, so all right. But you got to admit, in Wisconsin, Belts is up there too. In point,
I got to tell you though. So I bought my house. I'm literally two blocks from Leon's. So saying that you're going to go on a diet, but then when it hits about 7 o'clock at night, you feel like you want a little something. You just walk down the street. Oh man, there's nothing better.
Nothing better.
Nothing better.
Now, guys, so I haven't had Belts, Jim, but I have not. So Leon's is like your classic custard drive-in. Okay. It's been there literally since the 1950s.
Wow.
This is where when you have presidents or dignitaries in Oshkosh and they're driving through for a photo op, they take them to Leon's.
That's awesome. That's
so.
Yeah, I love those places.
Not intentionally, but you know, I'm like Mino. I'm watching my figure too.
Right.
Well, just by looking at you and looking at Mino, you're doing a hell of a lot better than he is.
Oh my God. Seriously.
I have not had Leon's custard like in 2 years, maybe three, like before pandemic.
Okay.
So tomorrow at noon, the Brandon, our camera guy, is part of our Why I Love Oshkosh. They're going to capture me having that first taste of custard, like it's like I've never had custard before.
Awesome.
Imagine that moment.
Tell us again how to watch all your stuff.
Just go to Discover Oshkosh.
Okay.
DiscoverOshkosh.com and just click on videos and you'll see the craft beer video is the last one. Hey, how'd you guys do with the cold IPAs up there?
Oh, I don't know. Todd took them all.
Todd kind of did.
Yeah.
Todd told us they were good.
We had one in the studio.
So they were really good. Yeah. Then he took the rest. Yeah.
So I'll tell you a quick story, Pat. True story. And I'll just put this out there. So I was going to meet Pat down at Fifth Ward in Oshkosh to have my first cold IPA down there citywide. And he was not there, but somebody walked. And so I had my cold IPA. And somebody walked in that kind of looked like him. So I introduced myself and called him Pat.
Oh, no. And it wasn't him.
Well, it wasn't. But, you know, I felt a little tipsy at that point. So.
I'm sorry, Todd, that I didn't meet you. I actually was at Bare Bones, which is one of our other craft breweries, because they had they have that sharp haze out there that I just love. And I was craving one. I'm sorry I blew you off that day.
That's okay. I'll see you at noon tomorrow. You owe me Leon's.
I'll send you the times because you're going to dig this.
Right. Can you find us like a real little country bar?
Oh, guys.
Love the little country bars.
That's part of... That's a big part of the reason why I just love Wisconsin so much.
Me too. Me too. Oh,
we're going to need a whole day. We've got some crazy. I mean, we can go to the little like corner taverns. Yeah. They still have them in Oshkosh, like in your neighborhood.
Yeah. Love those kind of places. That's
unbelievable.
That's still my dream is to run one of those places and live upstairs of it.
John.
Yeah.
You got to meet my wife. That's exactly what Dawn wants to do.
Yeah, we've talked.
Are you married, careful. John?
Her and I have talked
a couple times.
Yeah. And I want a 78-year-old woman who works behind the bar and she fries up the burgers and the onion rings and makes an old-fashioned and still does the mulch or whatever it's called.
Right.
I want that.
And she's been taking 10% every day cash.
She's got a condo in the Keys.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. We are simple men, aren't we?
Yes, we are. Very simple. Oh. That's my dream, is to have a little bar and live upstairs of it.
Okay, we as in you and John.
So I'm excited about this Oshkosh visit. I'm going to curate some neat things for you that you would not ordinarily see.
Excellent.
Right. That's my specialty. I'm the tour guide you didn't know you needed.
Love it. And we're doing that in Appleton as well. So it's just Tuesday travel. We're going to go to some unique places.
We want to go all over. If people have ideas, please let us know.
And then there's some bowling alley we're going to go to. Didn't you mention
that? Well, yeah. In Two Rivers.
Well, those are Two Rivers. Okay, yes. Yeah. So anyway, we got... I know we're on a day-to-day contract here, so
yeah, but, so we don't know how long it's gonna last. we're gonna make the most of it.
Is this in May? We thinking in May?
Sure.
Yeah, once the weather gets a little bit better. Yeah.
Perfect.
We're with Pat Tracy, Discover Oshkosh. You got to really check out his videos. They are fantastic. What else? Like, Pat, you've been all over the place. You've done these kind of things. It takes a lot to kind of trip your triggers, so to speak. What have you discovered lately that kind of trips your trigger?
The meat raffle.
Okay. All right.
Have you guys been to meat raffles?
I've hosted numerous ones.
John's part. That's his other
and
job.
Let's spin the wheel. Okay. 42789. What was it? 42789. 347. 42789. You win a pack of bratwursts. Marcy, you got that, I think. What? I think you got, what was the number again?
Okay. Guys, I don't want to tell you that I go to Deb's spare time on Saturday afternoons for meat raffle.
Okay.
Because then others will go there.
Okay.
It's a quarter of paddle. It's a quarter of paddle.
Yes.
And so every, and there's like 10 rounds.
Yes.
So every round, somebody wins like a big T-bone.
Yeah.
Or we've won something every week. We go there.
Yeah.
And you have a couple of drinks, you spend $10 on the meat raffle, and you walk home with a giant T-bone. Last week we had chicken stuffed with asparagus and cheddar.
Ooh, that sounds phenomenal.
Incredible.
Yeah.
But the fun part of the meat raffle is you're meeting the other meat raffle enthusiasts.
Absolutely.
That is the best part.
I've been to 100 meat raffles. No question about it.
Lord.
Yep.
Oh my Lord. So you just think I'm a nutcase because I've just, you know, I just discovered it 30 days ago.
Got a text here. After I release my video game that I've been developing, I want to make enough to retire to a small Wisconsin tavern just like the one you're talking about. Thank you. Let me know if you need a partner. Do you want to be my partner, Jim?
Nope.
Hey, I do have a fun tip for you guys, though.
Yeah.
Do we have a minute?
Yeah.
Okay. So we just had tax day. Everybody's going to be flush with cash. Those refunds are coming in.
Oh, yeah.
I believe.
I wrote a check. How'd you do that?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
I'll text you my accountant after the
Vito Gambino.
That lady who took 10% cash.
So yes.
Waterfest just put out their full lineup of 9 shows for the season.
Awesome.
And it's a little thing we do here in Oshkosh, like in April, May. You can buy the whole season pass. It's $100 for 9 shows. Okay.
Wow.
If you have 3 friends, you buy 3 of those season passes, you get 1 free. When you divide out the 4 of you, put in $300, it's $8 a show.
That's phenomenal.
And these are, this is, we've got this summer, we've got Los Lonely Boys, the Gin Blossoms.
Wow.
I love those Steely Dane guys from Madison.
Yep.
Right?
Yeah.
And so don't go blow your refund check on something crazy. Go to waterfest.org and buy your season Waterfest tickets because we've still got them. And they're going fast, and it's just a fantastic summer.
You know what I'm hoping to do? You know what I'm hoping to do? I'm hoping to have a boat by then, and I want to take my boat down right from here, right from outside here, 100 steps away, and take it right down to the alongside Waterfest, right there next to the stage almost. You park your boat, party on the boat, get off, and enjoy great music.
Mino,
yeah.
I got a guy
that's
going to hook you up right there on the dock.
Oh, man, you're the best. Man,
you'll probably have the band in there partying with you.
Oh, they will be. Show. Oh, trust me. They will be.
Yeah.
Pat, could you do a show with me every day?
I was just going to say, Pat's the new co-host.
Sorry, man. You know why? Because you don't,
a realist,
you don't live your life to squash my dreams. Okay? You don't get up every morning and say, how can I kill this guy's dreams?
As I get to know you, maybe I can evolve.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay.
Yeah, hey.
Thank you, Pat.
Job's open.
Pat,
all right.
Tell everybody once again how they could check out your videos.
DiscoverOshkosh.com. Why I love Oshkosh, and I hope to see you in Oshkosh soon.
You will.
We're going to. We want you to help be our tour guide.
I love you guys.
Right, you're the best.
Man.
Thank you so much, Pat. Pat Tracy, Discover Oshkosh. Take care, my friend.
Thank you, Pat.
I wish you were more like him.
You need a guy like that.
I wish you were more like him.
Hey, look, I got to be honest with you.
I'm going to be honest.
You need a guy like that to make a city work. The face of the city, the energy he's got, the deals he brings forward.
Yeah.
He knows the nooks and crannies of Oshkosh. Yeah. It's not just EAA stuff. And I can see why he's
concerned about other people fulfilling their dreams.
Well, yeah, he's just playing along because we're not charging.
No,
I'm definitely going to meet him up for some custard.
Yeah, that sounds really good.
Yeah, that sounds
absolutely
good.
Yeah, that actually sounds really good.
Yeah, but that before and after, two custards a day.
Well, you know what? We'll do the rock climbing challenge before that, because that'll burn up a lot of
and then we
carbs.
Won't feel guilty.
Yes.
Not that we ever have, but.
I don't even have that chromosome. All right. We got to set our quick break. Mind on the Mayor, back after this. Welcome back. Another great guest. Man, we've had some great guests today. Pat Tracy, Discover Oshkosh, fantastic.
He is the face of Oshkosh, and he works hard at that.
Absolutely.
Right? The videos, all the restaurants.
Can't
crannies,
wait to go down. Yeah. Ace Champion, Good Buffalo, Flute Festival in Madison. He's amazing. Mary Jane Herber, librarian, historian, Brown County Library, fantastic. Mandy Wilkie, Stroll Edge Room Magazine.
Yeah,
man, the energy she brings to the table, huh?
Entrepreneur.
And for to talk to like the young entrepreneurs mm-hmm. like you have in your classes, mm-hmm. she would just
cut right through
the BS. And,
yep.
So that's fantastic.
All right, before we go, I just want to talk. I want to plug this Margarita Bay event that's coming up at Epic tomorrow night. You know, you guys know that I work at the New Community Shelter. We have our annual fundraiser, and this is going to be fun. We have tickets, and Todd's going to play a song. And if you just text in the name of the song, it's kind of a tribute
to Jimmy Buffett.
To Jimmy Buffett. We got his band, the Landsharks, who have played with Jimmy Buffett, are coming up to Green Bay tomorrow night at the Epic, 5 p.m. And obviously the food is cheeseburgers and margaritas. And wear your Hawaiian shirt. Or where's he from? The Keys, right?
Yeah. John, hang on a second. My buddy John Kramer's here. Last time I bought a Caribbean shirt was for your wedding.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So wow.
Yes.
So that's what this thing is. You can wear sandals if you want, but it's very chill.
So I'm going to that event.
Oh, good.
I don't think he's on tut. Is he?
He is. Hang on.
Hang on. Oh, you're going to go to this event?
Yes, sir.
Oh, awesome. Okay.
Well, thank you for doing that. And those tickets were $100 each. I'm giving these away. Two tickets today and then two tickets tomorrow.
But that's right up your alley, right?
So I actually volunteered to take photos for the folks over there.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
That's awesome.
So
that's right. You're quite the photographer. Yes. Okay. So Todd, just play a song. We'll have somebody text in and we'll talk to John.
All right. So if you want to play along, download the Civic Media app right now. Choose WGBW or WISS and just tell me what song this is from Jimmy Buffett. I'm just going to play the intro and that's all you're going to get. So stand by one sec. I got to set this up.
And these tickets are worth $100
each.
Each.
And we're giving two tickets away to the people who.
That's fantastic.
Name this tune. I guess is that what
right.
it is?
Yeah.
Jimmy Buffett. Jimmy Buffett. This will be a fun event. I mean, I don't know if you can't go, but I'll definitely be there.
Name this Jimmy Buffett song.
I can name that tune in one note.
You're going already.
There you go.
There you go.
All right, All right. Text in the song. Todd will get your info, and then we'll get the tickets. Or you can come pick up the tickets.
All this studio has never smelled better.
So,
and it's nothing to do with us or our guest.
I saw Iron Duck post some photos on Facebook about breakfast burritos. I ran there this morning, and they're phenomenal.
Iron Duck. These look and smell so good, it's mind-boggling. Thank you for doing that.
Yeah. And we mentioned the Iron Duck on this show when we interviewed the
Sundance,
the coach, actually coach of the year, right, or something? I saw something. He got a big award, didn't he?
Yeah, like national coach of the year.
Right, right.
Yeah.
And his favorite restaurant is?
Iron Duck.
Yeah.
Which is it on Cardinal? Where is that?
It'd be Velp, wouldn't it?
It's all the way out on Velp.
It's all the way out on Velp.
Far outside of Velp.
Yeah. All right. Anyway, and they make they have great lunches and dinners, but John was going by there this morning, and he saw this burrito and brought it in, and that's all part of the diet, because John, I don't know if you tuned in earlier, but John brought in this shake he made home. He goes, you know, if you drink this, you won't be hungry all day, and he's on his second burrito.
So, they just smell so good, you can't get away from it.
That's what it is.
John Kramer is joining us here. John's going to be taking some pictures for us. John, of course, a long, how many year veteran of the U.S. Army?
30 years.
30 years. And now you've got a new gig, and you're being really successful. We actually have the picture hanging up out here that you took of that lighthouse. But you're working your butt off, going out about 3 in the morning, 4 in the morning to get the best shots of boats and things like that. And you've just developed into, you just really like this whole photography aspect right now, don't you?
Yeah, I went back to school for it, and I made myself busier than I've ever been. I know, I thought I was going to retire, but I guess not.
Awesome.
It is so true, though. Some of those nature shots, it's timing. I mean, sometimes the clouds, the sun, the dawn, dusk, whatever. So, you really have to
and go. Taking pictures of you guys, it won't be so much timing, but Photoshop.
That was going to be my next question.
Brush it out.
Because did you see that one that we've got hanging in the other room, that picture of me from that award I got that time?
High school picture.
No, it wasn't. But she actually let me sit there with her. I said, hey, can you feel that? Can you take away those bags under the eyes? Right. Can you? And she did it. And
darkened his hair.
And it's like, that's the real me that she captured.
Oh, my God.
That's the real me. Right?
Halloween.
You guys let me know how much you want me to touch him up.
Okay, a lot.
A lot.
No problem.
A lot.
John, we're talking about, I did a live remote one time over at the Reserve Center on Holmgren.
Yeah.
And they had the recruiters out there where, you know, people could come up and they could try the walk climbing wall. You say you didn't have to do that, though, even though you pretty much run that place.
No, I've never done the rock climbing wall.
Okay.
I'm actually, I went to airborne school and all that, but I actually have a tremendous fear of heights and edges. So
how did you jump out of an airplane if you have a fear of heights?
All my jumps were night jumps.
Meaning your eyes were closed.
I closed my eyes, yeah.
Wow. You're afraid of heights, but you are an airborne ranger.
Not a ranger.
Just airborne.
Yeah, just airborne.
That's incredible.
It is.
That's incredible. Did you have to jump off the towers?
Well,
to start off like early?
So when I went...
So I've had guys tell me that's scarier than jumping out of a plane.
So when I went as a sergeant first class in E7. So I was a student leader. So I was able to dodge some of that stuff.
Okay.
Yeah. And the towers, I didn't do that.
Okay.
I watched a kid land on a car and I'm like, no.
Oh, really?
He did a parachute landing fall on a car. And I'm like, I ain't doing that.
I was actually at Fort Bragg one time because we were playing a football game or a basketball game I was doing. And back, this was before 9/11, you could go on bases back then because they had a big museum. I wanted to see the Fort Bragg Museum.
Yep.
And they had those towers and some of those people were doing that. And it's like one of those things we're at the fair with the double Ferris wheel type thing and it stops and people are swinging up there. And it was that same feeling I got in my pit of my stomach watching those guys come off that tower.
Yeah, no thank you.
No. Wow. See, you didn't have to prepare like that when you made your jump, huh?
No, we just, I don't know, we just jumped. 3,000 feet wasn't that high, but, and we just jumped, and then they had a little radio, and it's toggle left, toggle right, and we just landed in a field. Tried to stand up, but didn't, you know, that wind's pretty brisk. But anyway, yes, that's.
How many jumps did you make?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm a 5-jump chump.
Okay.
Yeah, right. I just went through the course.
Got your wings.
Jump. Yep.
That's
yep.
funny.
Okay. Outstanding.
Right. Yeah.
A lot of respect for all you guys that do that, man.
Right.
And women.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Absolutely. Can never forget
you,
that.
And I know we're running out of time, but I think that's really cool that you had a career and then you went back and got another career at TC, right? It was local education.
Yep.
And now you're busier than you've ever been. And you're having a lot of fun, too. I mean, you had a great look on your...
It's something that I enjoy. And it's a great time and awesome experience. And
tell everybody who you work for.
I work for the Press Times. And I also work for Ambrosia Studios, too.
Fantastic.
Those guys are good guys.
Good for you. Isn't that fun, though, doing something you really love?
I mean,
instead of just, you know, I got to get a job and you didn't really need, but it's like, I'm just going to do something I really enjoy.
Right.
Yep.
And you can do it locally.
Yes, sir.
Phenomenal. You're going to make us look good. We're not even going to talk about what we're getting the pictures taken for yet, just in case we look at them and decide, nah. So make us that promise, okay?
Yeah. All right. We'll get the burritos out of the way for the pictures. Thanks for bringing them in.
Hey, at least I don't have to worry about that picture you took of me in Afghanistan with the skinniest Afghan in the world.
Yeah.
If I'm standing next to him, I don't have to worry about that. Thanks, John. Hey, everybody, thank you very much. Thanks for our phenomenal guest today. Todd, our producer, is just amazing. Thanks for everything. Back in tomorrow morning. Mine and the Mayor. See ya. Son of a son.